Hi, I'm Chris Wardlaw with Auto by Tell, and today we're here to review one of my favorite people movers, the 2013 Honda Pilot. Now, most people prefer SUVs to minivans, even though they can't carry as much cargo or as many people as a minivan can. The thing is, the Honda Pilot comes close. Now, this is an 8-passenger, 3-row, mid-size crossover SUV. It's offered in 4 different trim levels, ranging in price from $30,000 to $42,000. Front-wheel drive is standard, all-wheel drive is optional, and while this really can't go off-roading very far, and it only tows about 4,500 pounds, the Pilot is built for the way most people live most of the time. Let's find out why. Now, you may have noticed that the Pilot appears to have been designed with a T-square. This is a classic two-box design here, and that's because this is a utilitarian vehicle. It's not meant to be anything stylish per se. The only real styling elements that are on this vehicle are these flared fender wells. And part of the reason for that is because the Pilot's beauty is on the inside, kind of like with some of your best friends. Now, deep within the Pilot's protruding nose is a 3.5 liter V6, makes 250 horsepower, not a lot more torque than that. And it's got variable cylinder management, which means that it operates on fewer of its 6 cylinders under certain driving conditions to help conserve fuel. Now, the 4-wheel drive model is rated 17 miles per gallon in the city and 24 miles per gallon on the highway. I got about 19, and that included trips to Las Vegas, Santa Barbara, Disneyland. I mean, I went all over the place in this thing. I only got 19. And that's because I usually had at least 6 people in the car or a full cargo area or both. You'll probably do better if you spend as much time on the highway as I did. The engine is rated to tow 2,000 pounds if you've got front wheel drive, 4,500 pounds if you get all wheel drive. Now, one of our favorite things about the Pilot is that it has this flip up rear window, which allows you to carry longer items, you know, like maybe a surfboard or, I don't know, some new molding for the house. Also helps you stack things to the ceiling when you're taking a long trip. Without this kind of a window, the potential exists for things to just fall right out when you open the tailgate, and you know, that's no good. In fact, I don't think my wife would like very much that I'm treating her luggage that way. Matches my shirt. Another thing I really like about this, being the father of 2 young kids, is that my compact stroller rolls right in, plenty of room for the tailgate to close. Also, I can just toss it in just like that. No problem at all. Now, Honda says the Pilot will hold 18 cubic feet behind the 3rd row seat. You fold the 3rd row seat down, you got 47.7 cubic feet to deal with. Fold both rows of seats down, and the Pilot carries 87 cubic feet of cargo. Now, as you can see, because we removed the front seat headrest, 3 adults will fit easily in the Pilot's 2nd row seat. In fact, you can put 3 forward-facing child seats in the 2nd row seat. And the Touring model has these handy integrated sunshades, which if you have an infant riding in a reverse-facing seat, that's important because that sunlight, even through this privacy glass, can be pretty bright on a little one's eyes. Now, one of the best things about the Pilot is how utilitarian the interior is. Now, that doesn't sound all that romantic because, you know, people like to have their cars a little fancy, but how many of the tools you have in your garage that are fancy? They're all utilitarian, and this vehicle is a tool. So you've got things like this dashboard bin, you've got a huge storage console. Inside here on the Touring model, you have a 115 volt power outlet. Back here, you got video game jacks, all kinds of storage. I mean, there are 3 different storage areas in the door panels. You've got this little conversation mirror that lets you spy on everybody in the back seat. This is a really useful vehicle. One of the problems with it is, though, they've wasted a lot of space here on the center console, and all the controls are kind of squeezed together. Now, they're well marked, and it's a combination of buttons and knobs, which I really like, but things are a little bit busy. Honda has been working towards simplifying it. They're doing better. They've still got a ways to go. Perhaps the worst ergonomic flaw of this vehicle is this shifter location. When it's in drive and you're driving down the interstate and you want to change the radio station, you know how many times I did that and knocked it into neutral? Lots. Now, unlike most test cars, I actually spent a lot of time driving the Pilot. I've put 1,500 miles on this thing. Had family visiting from out of town, we loaded it up, we went to Las Vegas, we drove all over the place. And so I've learned a lot about this particular vehicle, especially its driving dynamics when it's full of people and cargo. And aside from the fact that the engine is noticeably taxed, especially when climbing a mountain grade, when the car is full, this thing drives really well. I mean, the handling, the steering, the suspension tuning, the brakes, barely perceptible differences when this vehicle is fully loaded. And you can't say that about too many cars, SUVs, minivans on the market today. Now, the Honda Pilot might not be the best looking vehicle on the road, especially in this brown color, but it is incredibly practical for families large and small. And while I do wish it got better fuel economy, and it would be nice if it offered modern safety features like blind spot information system or a lane departure warning system, the fact is, this is a safe SUV. It's an affordable SUV. It's an incredibly practical SUV, and it's a comfortable SUV. It might just be the best minivan substitute you can buy. For Auto by Tell, I'm Chris Wardlaw, and I'll see you around the next bend in the road.